The modern definition of abstract group was given by Cayley. Cayley's theorem is one of the classic theorems of modern algebra. This theorem links a given finite group and groups of permutations. A group of permutation is a subgroup of some symmetric group. The statement of this theorem is every finite group is isomorphic to a permutation group. Cayley's theorem. The statement of Cayley's theorem is every finite group is isomorphic to permutation group. Proof. Let G be a finite group. Let A belong to G. Then for every X belongs to G, by closure axiom, A into X also belongs to G. Let us consider a function F suffix A from G to G. The group G to itself defined by F suffix A of X is equals to A into X for A belongs to G. The function F suffix A has domain and codomain, both are the same group. Therefore, whenever we write the elements of G, it is better to specify whether the element belongs to the domain group or the codomain group. Here the elements of G, the domain group, are of the form x, y, z, so on. Whereas the elements of G, codomain, are of the form f suffix a of x, that is ax, ay, az, so on. Here we consider a is a fixed element, but we can define the function f suffix a for each and every element of G. Suppose B belongs to G, we can define F suffix B. Suppose L belongs to G, we can define F suffix L by F suffix L of X is equals to LX for L belongs to G. Now, this theorem consists of three parts. The first part, we are going to show that F suffix A is a permutation group on G. We know the definition of permutation. That is a one-to-one and onto mapping of a finite set is called a permutation. Therefore, to show that F suffix A is a permutation, we have to show that F suffix A is one-to-one and onto. At the same time, we have to check whether F suffix A is well defined or not. In the first part of the claim, A, F suffix A is well defined. What do you mean by well defined? This is a function, we are defined F suffix A from G to G by F suffix A of X is equal to AX for A belongs to G. Well defined, we mean, suppose a function F is from the set A to B is well defined if take any two elements of A and make them equal. Consider any two elements of A, namely A comma B, and write A equals to B. Then show that the images of A and B under the function F are also equal. That is, if you take A comma B belong to G, A equal to B implies F of A is equals to F of B. To prove F of A is well defined, since F suffix A is from G to G, we have to choose two elements from the domain set and make them equal. So to prove F suffix A is well defined, we have to show that X is equals to Y implies F suffix A, X is equal to F suffix A of Y for all X comma Y belong to the domain group. Therefore, we are going to choose two elements X and Y from G and let X is equal to Y. Then we have to show that the images of X and Y under the function F suffix A are also equal. F suffix A is well defined. So choose two elements x and y from the domain. Since all you have chosen A belongs to G, by closure property AX and AY both belong to the codomain group G. Let x be equal to y pre-multiplied by A. That is, AX is equals to AY. What is AX? By the definition of f suffix a, ax is equal to f suffix a of x. What is ay? By the definition of f suffix a, ay becomes f suffix a of y. Therefore, ax is equal to ay implies f suffix a of x is equals to f suffix a of y by the definition of f suffix a. Therefore, if any two elements are equal in the function f suffix a, then their images also must be equal. That means f suffix a is well defined. We shall now show that f suffix a is 1 to 1. What is 1 to 1? A function f is from a to b is 1 to 1 if f of a equal to f of b implies a equal to b for all a comma b belong to a. That is, 1 to 1 is a reverse process of well defined, or well defined is the reverse process of 1 to 1. But in 1 to 1 we assume that images of two elements are equal. Then we have to show that those two elements must be equal. Therefore, to prove f suffix a is 1 to 1, we have to show that f suffix a of x is equals to f suffix a of y implies x is equal to y for all x comma y belong to G, the domain set. For x comma y belong to G, f suffix a of x comma f suffix a of y belongs to G codomain. Now assume that the images of x and y under the function f suffix a are equal. That is, f suffix a of x is equal to f suffix a of y. So by definition of f suffix a of x is equals to ax, f suffix a of y is equals to ay. Therefore, this implies ax is equals to ay. This implies x is equal to y by left cancellation law. That is, the element a on the left hand side of ax and the left hand side of ay get cancelled, and hence x is equal to y. Thus, we are taken the images of x and y are equal. Now we have proved that those two elements are equal. Therefore, the function f suffix a is 1 to 1. Now we have to show that f suffix a is onto. What is the definition of onto? A function f is from a to b is onto if for every b belongs to b. That is, we choose an arbitrary element b from capital B, that is codomain set. For that b belongs to the codomain set, there must exist one element small a from the domain set such that the function is true. That is, f of a equals to b. Now, to prove that f suffix a is onto, we have to show that for every b, actually here b belongs to b, now we are taking this b equal to x, x belongs to g, codomain set, there exists a inverse x belongs to g, that is a domain. It's true because x is an element of G, G is a group, A belongs to G and G is a group, therefore A inverse exists in G, and hence A belongs to G implies A inverse belongs to G. Now X belongs to G, A inverse belongs to G, by closure axiom A inverse in the X belongs to G, and this G is a domain set such that the function is true. What's the function? F suffix A of A inverse of x is equals to A into A inverse of x, that is equal to x. For x belongs to G, where G is a codomain group, we know that A belongs to G and G is a group, therefore inverse exists for every element of G. Thus, A belongs to G implies A inverse also belongs to G. Now, A inverse belongs to G, X belongs to G. Therefore, A inverse into X belongs to G by closure axiom. Thus, for every X belongs to G in the codomain set, there exists A inverse of X belongs to G, the domain group, such that F suffix A of A inverse of X is equals to, by definition of F suffix A, that is equal to A into A inverse into X, and use associative property, this can be written as A into A inverse into X. Now A into A inverse is nothing but E, because A is an element of G and A inverse also an element of G. By inverse axiom, A into A inverse equals to E. Therefore, it is equal to E into X. By identity axioms, E into X is X. Thus, for every X belongs to G in the codomain, there exists A inverse of X in the domain set, such that F suffix A of A inverse of X is equal to X. That is, F suffix A is onto. Thus, F suffix A is 1 to 1 and onto. Therefore, F suffix A is a permutation on G. Just now, we have shown that F suffix A is a permutation on G, for A belongs to G. For the second part, let us consider G dash is equals to set of all permutation F suffix A, such that A belongs to G. That is, we know that for every A belongs to G, there exists one permutation F suffix A. Suppose G has 100 elements, then we have 100 F suffix A, F suffix 1, 2, F suffix 2, so on, F suffix 100. So we are going to consider all those permutation as a set, and we call that set as G dash. Therefore, let G dash be equals to set of all permutations F suffix A, where A belongs to G. That is, G dash be the set of all permutations defined on G corresponding to every element of G. Now we are going to show that G dash is a group with respect to permutation multiplication. That is, to show that G dash is a group, we have to prove four things. One is closure axiom, second is associative, third is identity, fourth one is inverse axiom. Let us take the closure axiom. In the second part, A, closure axiom. For the closure axiom, we have to choose two elements from G, that is A comma B belong to G, such that F of A and F of B must be in G dash, because G dash consists of all permutations defined on G. To prove G dash is closed with respect to permutation multiplication, we have chosen F suffix A and F suffix B be two elements in G dash. Now we have to show that the product, namely F suffix A into F suffix B, also belongs to G dash. For this, consider F suffix A into F suffix B of X by definition of F suffix A. Let us use associative property here, and by definition of F suffix A, F suffix A of X is equals to AX. Therefore, F suffix B of X is equals to BX. And hence, that is equal to F suffix A into BX. This is by the definition of F of A. Again, let us consider BX as X here, and A equal to A. Again, by the definition of F suffix A, here F suffix A of BX will be A into BX. This is the one, A into BX. What are A, BX? A, BX are elements of G, and G is a group. Since G is a group, associative law holds good in G. Therefore, A into BX can be written as AB into X. Again, by the definition of F suffix A, we know that A into X is equal to F suffix A of X. Here we have a AB into X. Therefore, AB into X will be F suffix AB of X. So, this is by the definition of F suffix A. Thus, F of A into F of B equal to F of A into B, and F suffix AB is of the form F suffix A, where AB is an element of G. Because whenever A comma B belong to G, A into B also belongs to G. Therefore, AB is an element of G, and since G dash consists of all the permutations defined on G for every element of G, since A into B is an element of G, F suffix A into B is a permutation, and hence this must be in G dash. Thus, F of A into F of B equal to F suffix AB. G dash is closed under permutation multiplication. Hence, F suffix A comma F suffix B belongs to G dash implies F suffix A into B belongs to G dash. That is, G dash is closed with respect to permutation multiplication. Now, associativity. Let A comma B comma C belong to G. Therefore, their corresponding permutations, namely F suffix A comma F suffix B comma F suffix C, must be in G dash. Just now we have shown that F suffix A in the F suffix B equal to F suffix AB. Therefore, this F suffix A in the F suffix B can be written as F suffix A into B into F suffix C. This by 1. Again, use 1. This is like A, this is like B. Therefore, F suffix A in the F suffix B equal to F suffix A into B. Therefore, F suffix A into B into F suffix C equal to F suffix AB into C. AB into C. What are ABC? ABC are elements of G, and G is a group, and associative law holds good in G. Therefore, this AB into C can be written as A into BC. Therefore, that is equals to F suffix A into BC, associativity in G. Using 1, F suffix A into BC can be written as F suffix A into F suffix BC. Again, we are going to use 1. That is, F suffix B into C can be written as F suffix B into F suffix C. Thus, F suffix A, F suffix B into F suffix C equals to F suffix A into F suffix B, F suffix C. Therefore, G dash satisfies associativity with respect to permutation multiplication. Now, existence of identity. Let E be the identity in G, because G is a group, identity exists. Therefore, let E be the identity in G. For every element in G, there must be a permutation. Therefore, here E belongs to G implies F suffix E must be in G dash. Therefore, F suffix A in the F suffix E equals to F suffix A into E by 1. Fix, what is A into E? A is an element of G. E is identity in G. Therefore, A into E equals to A. And F suffix E into F suffix A equals to F suffix E into A by 1. And E into A is equal to A in G. Therefore, that is equal to F suffix A. That is, when you multiply F suffix A with F suffix E, we are getting F suffix A. That implies F suffix A is the identity in G dash. Therefore, identity in G dash exists, and it is F suffix E. Now, the fourth one is existence of inverse. If A belongs to G, then A inverse must be in G, because G is a group, inverse exists for every element in G. And for this A inverse in G, there must be a permutation, namely F suffix A inverse. and this F suffix A inverse must be in G dash. Equation 1 says that F suffix A into F suffix B equals to F suffix A into B. Therefore, F suffix A into F suffix A inverse is equals to F suffix A into A inverse by 1. And we know that A inverse is the inverse of A in G. Therefore, by inverse axiom, A into A inverse is equals to E. Therefore, F suffix A into A inverse is equals to F suffix E. And F suffix A inverse into F suffix A is equals to F suffix A inverse into A by 1. And A inverse into A equals to E. Therefore, F suffix A inverse into A equals to F suffix E. Thus, F suffix A into F suffix A inverse is equal to F suffix E. That is equal to F suffix A inverse into F suffix A. Therefore, inverse exists for A. Since A being an arbitrary element in G, we say that every element in G dash has inverse, and inverse of F suffix A is equals to F suffix A inverse. Thus, we have shown that G dash is closed. G dash is associative, identity exists in G dash, and every element in G dash has inverse. Thus, G dash satisfies all the four axioms of a group, and hence G dash is a group. Thus, F suffix A is a permutation on G, and G dash is equals to the set of all permutation F suffix A where A belongs to G is a group. Therefore, G dash is a permutation group. G is a finite group and G dash is a permutation group. The third part and the final part of this theorem is we have to show that G is isomorphic to G dash, where G is a finite group, G dash is a permutation group. The statement says that every finite group is isomorphic to a permutation group. To prove G is isomorphic to G dash, first of all we have to define a function from G to G dash. Then we have to show that function is 1 to 1, onto and homomorphism. For that, let us first define a function from G to G dash. We know that elements of G are of the form A, B, C or X, Y, Z. Elements of G dash are of the form F suffix A, F suffix B, F suffix C, so on. Therefore, now let us define a function phi from G to G dash by phi of A is equal to F suffix A, for A belongs to G. Remember that this A is from G, whereas F suffix A is from G dash. Now we have to show that this phi is 1 to 1, onto and structure preserving, that is homomorphism. This is a function we have defined from G to G dash, where G is a finite group, G dash is a permutation group, defined by phi of A is equals to F suffix A, for A belongs to G. A, phi is 1 to 1. To show that it is 1 to 1, we have to choose two elements from G dash, that is phi of A is equal to phi of B. Now we have to show that A equals to B, that is the images are equal implies the elements are equal. These are the images, phi of A and phi of B are the images of A and B respectively. Now they are equal. Now we have to show that the elements A is equals to B. What is phi of A? By the definition of phi of A, it is F suffix A. Phi of B is F suffix B, and apply upon X, where X belongs to G. We know that the function F suffix A is defined by F suffix A of X is equal to AX. Therefore, F suffix A of X is equal to AX, F suffix B of X is equal to BX, Therefore, this implies AX is equals to BX by the definition of F suffix A. X being an element of G and right cancellation law holds good in any group. Therefore, cancel this X. This implies A equals to B. Thus, the images of A and B are equal implies the elements are equal. Therefore, phi of A equal to phi of B implies A equal to B for A comma B belong to G. That implies phi is 1 to 1. We shall now show that phi is on 2. The function phi is defined as phi of A equal to F suffix A for A belongs to G, where A belongs to G and F suffix A is from G dash. To prove phi is on 2, we have to choose one element from G dash. For that element, there must exist an element A in G such that this function is true. Since for F suffix A belongs to G, where is A from? A is from G. Such that, let us check the function. Such that the function phi of A is equals to F suffix A. Thus, for every permutation in G dash, that element must belong to G such that the function is true. Therefore, phi is on 2. Now, the last one is phi is structure preserving. That is, phi is a homomorphism. Let A comma B belong to G. This implies AB belongs to G by closure axiom. F is a homomorphism if F of AB is equal to F of A into F of B for A comma B belong to G. Now consider phi of A into B. By definition of phi, that is equals to F suffix AB. And we know that F suffix A into B is F of A into F of B. Equation number 1 already we have mentioned. Therefore, that is equal to F suffix A into F suffix B by 1. What is F suffix A? F suffix A is phi of A. What is F suffix B? F suffix B is phi of B by definition of phi. Therefore, phi of A into B equal to phi of A into phi of B. That is, phi is 1 to 1, on 2 and homomorphism. Therefore, phi is an isomorphism from G to G dash, or we say G is isomorphic to G dash, where G dash is called a regular permutation group. Thus, every finite group is isomorphic to a permutation group. This completes the theorem. Cayley's theorem is true even if the group G is not finite. If G is infinite, then the statement is every group is isomorphic to a permutation group.